Greetings from Indonesia. My name is Paduka and finally I'm back with second behind the art Cinefic edition, where I'm talking about the picture that I made, talking about insights and maybe like special tricks that I found a way, and also explaining several things that are like tiny tidbits around where I've done several things that are just different. Now, my apologies were for taking too long in this second one. The first one was actually like, yeah, I can say like around a month ago. But there's a problem when I'm trying to create the second one. Okay, I'm talking to you right now. The first problem is actually, this is my second try. My previous try was something different that I decided to drop. Well, actually not drop, I haven't deleted that picture yet, that drawing. It's just something like stalling them out for later. This is because the previous drawing is actually something that is just really like needs a huge amount of detailing, like colors, shades, and fuzzies, because it actually features rugs, sofas, and flooring. And I'm just like, oh, you know what? I'm having zero experience in this at the moment, so I decided to actually just stall it out and look for something else. So I'm just thinking about going with the same theme as before, light, sweet, and simple. So this is what I'm coming up with. Something like, something that is sweet and simple. Like, you know, having a nap on someone's shoulder is something sweet and something normal. And also, it features benches and bushes and clouds. Well, how does that perform? Well, let's actually start this way one by one, simply start from the lining. Now let's start this with the lining itself, because the first step that I have to come with is actually to create, like, well, I was about to say the first thing to do is actually sketches, but sketches actually is pretty much include lining and filling these outlines with regions. So the first thing that I do is actually creating the simple regions. Start from the head, like from this one. This is actually just a simple region, like going around and. Hold on a sec. There you go. Just like, yeah, this is the first time I'm starting with this head. I'm just like shaping it up. And from there, it's just like going all anywhere I go. It's like creating the neck, creating the shoulder, creating the torso. So basically, I'm starting from creating the base body, like head, neck, shoulder, and stuff. We're actually adding the extra stuff like eyes, eyebrows, hairs, and yeah, stuff like that. And actually, like these benches and these bushes, it's actually coming up on later time. Oh my goodness. Okay, sorry. It actually took a lot of time to scroll up and down, or even zooming. Zooming took a lot of time. That's because this is just like a huge drawing with a huge amount of factors and shades. Because every time it zooms, it took a lot of time to render everything. It doesn't matter if you do use the scroll, it actually like rendering it based on how many times you scroll. Like if you scroll two times, it will render two times, because this is how the preview works. It doesn't like lock your last scroll. It's just like one by one. Let's put that scroll in aside, scroll in and zoom in. Now I found something like really easier trick to just create these lines and fill it up with outlines. Now in my previous video, I said that the way that I'm doing it is actually like using create a couple region, like usual, a couple region, line and alpha, and then and group them, and then on our group, create another region, like composite region, group it in different one, and click that composite and the line, link them, link the origin, link the vertices, like this one you need to link, this one and this one, and I found out there is actually a way easier way. So here's the simplest stuff, the simpler example. Now, let's ignore this for a moment. So this is the region. As you can see, it's actually called region. This is because I'm not actually creating it from adding a new one or copying these spaces into it and do the linking and change thing. It's not like that. Instead, I'm right clicking and there is actually an option called make region. This is what I choose. And it actually worked pretty well. Like, this might be just like, if you go with one line and one region, it doesn't have much of a help. But then if you go like, hold on, if I can find, hold on a second, definitely not on those hairs, forgot where it is. This is an example like this. This the lines. These are lines and alphas, by the way. There are three couples of them. I'm just like click this, right clicking, and make region, and then group them in the, here. There you go. There are three regions. It's actually way easier because, let's say you have the base like, it's ungrouped yet, and then you right click and make region, right click and make region all of that. Do all them all. And then you select these regions 1, 2, 3. You select them when it's like once created. Select them all, and then it's like group it. Bam! You got a full group of region, and the only thing you need to do left is actually to group all the other layers except for that group. Like this one. Let me just demonstrate you. Like this, I'm making region. Hold on a second. It took a lot of time to render. Make region. And then one more time, right click and make region. Select them all. Hold on a second. 1, 2, 3. And group them. And this is my region group. And after that, I can just like select these and this and group them. And we'll create another, it will be created as another group. And then after that, you can just like arrange the groups like really easy. Instead of doing the leveling, like this, and especially if you have a lot of vectors going on and the shades going on like what I'm doing, you can just like select these, group them and arrange them. It's actually way easier in that way. So yeah, I'm kind of like finding new things as well when drawing this, like that one. And yeah, that's pretty much how the line and region works. Now move on to the next step, which is like the hardest part, of course, and obviously shading. But before shading, let's actually talk about these special things like you have seen in the background, like these benches and the bushes and the clouds as well. Alright, now let's talk about these benches. Now you have seen like it's kind of drawing having this like this beautiful patterns like that you see always in like when you chop a wood. It's called, what is it called, the circle of year? I don't know, it's the age circle, was it like that? I don't know, I can't understand that. I can't find the right term for the English, but it's simply those textures that you can see in wooden stuff that are not polished, fully polished or fully painted or fully coated with something else, except varnish. Of course varnish makes it beautiful. Now you can see these lines, it's like having these browns or the dark browns like oak woods and stuff. It's actually drawn one by one. Well, not entirely one by one. So here's how it works. First, I'm drawing like the obvious patterns of how it works. I'm just searching around the internet and found several results of them. And just like, so the way I'm doing is creating a big color and then going smaller. I change the color to something lighter. It goes like that. And it goes like that. It goes like that. The smaller it is, the brighter the color is, and just like that, smaller, and finally into the core. Same goes to the rest of these things. So I decided that I need to copy just this base, the entire base, and paste it somewhere else. Well, actually not into all of them, not just like putting on the whole spray. Hold on a second, my synth kinda, oh no. Hold on a second. Alright, we are back. Sorry for the crash. Yep. As I said before, this picture have a lot of factors inside, so yeah, bear with me with this. Now I have to bear with the software as well. I'm sorry, I forgot to maximize the screen. I need to maximize it. Okay. Now as you can see, as I've told before, the texture that I've done here is just like drawing these one thing and just like copy them all and paste them all over the place. Like this one, hold on a second, let me scroll a bit to the right, and yeah, there you go, until here. And after that, it doesn't end there, it doesn't end here. I copied the entire texture from this plank to this plank. As you can see, the pattern is almost the same. I'm just doing several changes like mirroring and different shift. And same goes to this plank as well on the left and the right. Yeah, I don't know why I'm doing this, but it's actually pretty cool. Now let's move on to the bushes. Alright, I have to start this bush part by saying this. I'm doing too much work for a tall waste. Like, really a tall waste. Now, you only see, like, just a few bits of shrubs here. Like, shrubs or bushes, whatever we call it. I don't know what's the difference. But probably, like, maybe shrubs has more wild grass in it. I don't know. But it's pretty much a waste. So, you have seen, like, just a few bits of this. But let me just show you how much I've done to this one silly bush. So there are two bushes here. I've drawn two. Well, no, I only draw one. But let me see just how crazy it is. Select all child layers, and this is it. Yep. Now, I'm not gonna expect you to do the whole thing that I've did here, but what I've did is simply to create a big shape, a big oval shape, oval-like shape or anything, polygon-ish, and create like curvy edges around the circle to create a bush or bushes, whatever. Yeah, I'm just like, but it, okay, never mind. I was a bit wrong on that one, but it's essentially the same. I'm creating, instead of doing the whole shape first, I'm creating the edge, the, you know, the curvy part, the curvy part of the bush, and I'm creating them like in different variation, different shapes. That's why you see a lot of these here on the edges. And there's a huge factor like circling them and covering the leftovers, the empty shapes of them. And after I'm doing that, I duplicate the bush and move it here. And what do you see? What do you see from here? Just a bit bush. And I've done a lot of work into that. So I'm doing something a bit wasteful, but at least I've learned something. I feel silly about this now. Really, feel silly. Now let's move on to the clouds, but I'm going to do it right away, no cuts this time. The clouds is actually simple, it's almost the same as the bush. So I've looking around for the tutorial for clouds, and I found like barely anything that I can just try it out, like actually, or even duplicating it, because the clouds have a lot of gradients, colors, and just like several thickness and around the colors, like, oh my goodness, insane. And then I've looked around in with different search tag, creating clouds in Inkscape, because they both essentially the same. Like, you create in Inkscape, you create with vectors. In here, you create with vectors, but with animation feature as well. But still, I like Synfig much more because of its like superior ability to just tinkering around with advanced outlines. I actually like that. Okay, move down aside. The trick that I found is actually something like this. Now, as you can see here, I'm having cloud bits within this simple cloud. This is because the tutorial I've seen is actually making good use of a spray tool in Inkscape, which essentially taking a group of this, like this simple group, and just like popping down, like, yeah, just doing some sort of clone or duplicating or copying, and you just like place them up here. It's like doing a stamp, but it's not a stamp tool. It's a spray tool. I think it's pretty cool. I haven't tried it yet, so I'm trying to do the same here. But instead of using this, the I don't know, it's might gonna be called something like duplicate tool, yeah, or duplicate layer. I'm just doing it one by one, as you can see. I'm just like create one and duplicate, create one, duplicate, create one, duplicate. The reason behind that is actually because I want to have a full control with my cloud bits, because that's how the spray tool works. At least that's what I've seen in Inkscape tutorial. Not Inkscape manual, where spray tool are divided by three types. One is clone, one is group, and one is by path. I don't know. The difference by three of them is actually pretty much different. When in group, we can control each of the spray or each of the part that you spray on. As for clone, one original shape that you use like to copy the spray will affect the whole rest of the clone. And as for path, yeah, it's pretty much based on paths. Any overlapping regions gonna get removed with paths. That's how it works in Inkscape. But yeah, I think I'm doing a good job with the clouds. As you can see here, I'm just like doing things like that. I did actually do several rotations to make different variations of it. I also need to make sure that I do the leveling so that the bottom part is actually visible while the top part is just like these white clouds. And after that, yep. As you can already guess, I copy the cloud, I duplicate the cloud, and put it in here. So yeah, that's how pretty much I've learned like how to texture and how to create like several unique things like in wood, in bush, in clouds, and yeah. And also several things like filling the outlines. But we're not done yet. We are finally going to the craziest part that I've ever done, and it took me like two days to contemplate. Well, not contemplate, more like putting a lot of thoughts on it. And it's actually the shading. So yeah, let's go to the shading then. Now let's get to the hardest part in this drawing, which is actually the shading. Now, as you can see here, it's actually just like a small factor. Let's like look at the shade. It's actually pretty small, but I actually need to put a lot of hard work within it. Now, yeah, you can actually see that I've done two layers. One is this thing. This is actually an alpha layer to make sure that I cut unneeded feather edges, and this is the actual shade. So it's almost the same as if I put it on top of here, like above the region layer, and just put it on as onto. But the hard part about it is actually, if I put it in top of this and I have a huge feather, it will just spill over everywhere. And that means I have to work a lot harder on which area I should alpha. Now, yeah, you can see I only need to just cut a few areas. If I have to put this thing here above the region, as per usual how I shade, the feather gonna spill off everywhere, and I have to create a more bigger alpha to cut them all. So I decided to do that. So I decided to do it just like putting it in here and here, just like in between. And yeah, I use composite because the shade actually affects head as well. Remember how the shade works? And when I thought that's the most effective solution, well, it's actually not. There are actually a different way to shade. Depends on what are the case. Now take a look at this thing. And let me just get you to the shade cut. This is actually different. I'm actually using composite to the shade, just like that. Oh wait, no, it's not composite, it's onto. Okay, sorry. I'm sorry. And I actually put it above the region. Despite of the potential that the shade might gonna spill off everywhere, in which in this case, I actually need to spill off this feather wherever I want it to be. It's like in a huge area. And it actually worked pretty well, and I don't need to take a lot of time to cut these areas. As you can see, I don't even use the alpha, it doesn't even need it. Now, my conclusion to that is actually two. First, if I have to shade small areas like this, I can just use the small shade with the cuts. As you can see here. Oh, sorry, that one got the alpha disabled, this one. As you can see here, this one have the alpha activated, and the shade is activated as well. So yeah, that's how it works. So the first one, if the area is small and possible to cut without using a lot of alpha area, I'll just use it. But if I really need to spill off a lot of shade, I pretty much better use this thing. Just like do onto above this region or wherever I want it to be. Probably just like put this shade cut deeper inside, depend on wherever I want it, and I don't need to use the cut anymore. It's actually pretty great. So that's all of my insights and findings in my second synthetic drawing, which is which I would like to call it power nap. There you go, my English is right. Yeah, because yeah, as you can see, she's just like sleeping for let's just say maybe like 5 minutes or so. She must be tired, and I think this is like my favorite so far among some of the past drawings I've done, either inside this video or outside this video. This is actually my favorite so far. And I really expect myself to actually do this and finish every single drawing at least 2 weeks once. But if everything went wrong, especially with my schedule and busyness in campus, it might gonna take maybe as long as 1 month as like this. As this one you just watch, is actually just like 1 month later, or maybe like 1 month and 2 days, I don't know exactly. But yeah, I'm planning to do this in the future, and I don't know, if I have done better, maybe I can go to something even bigger and actually make use of the entire Synfix feature. Well, not even Synfix feature, but the main purpose of this software, which is to animate. I don't know, maybe soon? Maybe anytime soon? I don't know, but as for now, this drawing is actually pretty much something that I can do on my meantime, among other of my business. Thanks for watching, cheers and love, and I'll see you again next time. Bye bye!